The book was very successful. It was translated into various languages, as you can see, in Italian, in German, in Russian, and Latvian. Then, following that, we had more projects funded by the Lifelong Learning Program. Map4ID, and again, this creates a link between our projects and MELA, for example. The first one, Map4ID, is museums as places for intercultural dialogue, and also produced a handbook, a publication here. The format we chose for this project was that of engaging 30 institutions in Europe to carry out pilot projects in the different countries, being inspired by the guidelines that we developed in the working group. So in the book, you also find 30 examples of how intercultural dialogue was practically put into place and carried out. Another one on volunteers for cultural heritage and museums. We also have a publication out of this. And this was a sort of like a bridging project, Mumbai Museums Meet Adult Educators, carried out last year, which actually resulted basically in a conference to bring the two sectors together, and was the bridging project to this, which is now our current project, also a network project, LEM. You find the brochures outside, which is a Grundtvig network funded also for 3 years, and trying to look at museums both as learning places and as learning organizations, so learning from the community, from the public, from other agents, and so on. This is a rather ambitious project because we have a very large, not only because it tries to look at museums and what they can do to meet the challenges of the European Agenda 2020, but also because we are in a very large partnership of 23 partners from 17 countries and the United States. For the first time, the Grundtvig program allowed to have one partner from outside Europe. So we have the University of Denver with the Museum of Anthropology. We are very ambitious in the sense that we intend to grow very much, and we have no limits as far as the associate partners that we want together. And so you're also very welcome to become an associate partner, which doesn't cost anything. Our website will go live next week, and there you will find the possibility of becoming an associate partner. We will have a mobility scheme within the project. The project really started at the beginning of December last year, so it's very new. And we have working groups. These working groups will also produce reports. One of the working groups, for instance, and this is where I see another possibility of working together, focuses on the museums of the 21st century. So again, there's ground to do some joint work there. This is the still undisclosed homepage of the LEM project, which is in fact not only a website to inform about the project, but to inform all interested subjects about the themes that the project addresses. And I'm also representing another network here, which is NEMO, the Network of European Museum Organizations. I think it is very important for you to get in touch and to disseminate the information of both European projects through this network. NEMO is a network of museum organizations, so museums associations where they exist, or say umbrella organizations at European level. These are some of the web pages. It basically tries to lobby to the European Union on behalf of museums, and also provide information to museums on relevant European initiatives, and create the conditions for an exchange of information and communication between museums. These are the members and the countries where NEMO is represented, so 32 countries. We like to say that NEMO represents actually 35,000 museums in Europe. It's not really so, but On the NEMO website, you will also find the topics that you can look into and where you will find relevant materials. Also, I didn't put this slide on, under news here, news, it should be, activities and news, if you open that section, you will find information about this conference today. So. NEMO also publishes, has an e-newsletter and publishes a news twice a year. And again, I brought some specimens which are gone. So I think, again, it's very important to liaise with all these different actors, be it projects, other projects, be it organizations which are active at regional, national, or European level. And so I decided to finish this presentation with a list of contacts. First of all, our own contact. We are very close here. So this is a physical invitation to visit us in Via Galliera 21. Or else on our website, and these are the contacts of the other organizations or projects I mentioned. Thank you.